You're looking at the Cosmo Communicator. It's the sequel to the Gemini Communicator that we saw earlier this year, which is a reinvention of the classic communicator device. So a PDA, a screen, and a keyboard all in one device. Now, the Cosmo Communicator is special because it's designed to be more of a complete device than the original one, which was, if we're all honest, rather niche. This is designed to be much more appealing to regular smartphone buyers, somebody who wants a more complete device than the original. What makes it more complete? Well, we have to look at the outside of another version. We're actually looking at two early versions here, which is why I'm swapping over mid-video. This is what makes it more complete. On the Cosmo, we've got an exterior display. Now, the exterior display was not a feature of the original Gemini. Here, this is completely interactive. What the company has done, Planet Computers, is they've made it so if you're using this as a regular phone, there's really no need to open the device. You can do most things on the exterior touchscreen. So if there's an incoming call, you can answer it. If you get messages, you can scroll through them. You can reply, we're using quick replies or slightly more complex replies. So what they're saying is if you've got stuff to do, you don't have to open the device and use the enormous keyboard and the touchscreen if you don't want to. That's a really sensible addition. Beyond that, as you'll see, there's two sections above and below. Above is a new 24 megapixel camera, so the imaging quality is going to be far superior to the original. And below this is a fingerprint sensor, adding security and a more modern aspect to the device. It's also going to act as a smart key, so you're going to be able to interact with the touchscreen, do other things through this as a shortcut key and things like that. Inside, we'll go back to the other one. I wonder why it's not working on this prototype. The keyboard has been refined. It's going to have a backlight as well, making it a far more complete model of actually doing some work with it rather than it not being backlit on the original. Underneath, on the final version, there's going to be little feet so that when this is rested on a table, it's going to stay where you put it. Otherwise, the design is actually fairly similar. The hinge itself hasn't changed. The bodywork hasn't changed particularly. Inside, there have been some additions. This now uses MediaTek's new P70 processor. Anyone who's been following MediaTek recently will know the P70 has got artificial intelligence abilities, far more so than we've seen on many mid-range processors from the company. There's 6 gigabytes of RAM. There's a internal 5 megapixel selfie cam. There's a 3.5mm headphone socket. There's a Type-C USB port for charging. It still runs Android and it runs Android 9 Pie. And there's support for Linux as well if you want to install that separately. Another really nice addition to using this device for certainly for people who enjoy using a PDA, adding Linux is a big thing. Weight-wise, not much has changed. It's still a weighty beast. This is 300 grams, so it's not going to be slipping in your pocket very easily. But there's still much to be said about this form factor. We are looking more these days at iPads and tablets with keyboards. Well, this is sort of somewhere in between. Really quite a nice form factor. Currently, you're going to buy this on Indiegogo. The campaign launched about a month ago while we're making this video and has gained enormous support. At the end of the campaign, this is going to cost around $800, but you can get it for less than that if you buy it through Indiegogo at the moment. The campaign's going to continue running, but there's no guarantee that price is going to stay. So if you really want one, it's a good idea to get in quickly and get it for that lower cost. So this is the Cosmo Communicator, the next version of the future of the PDA device.